All right, Billy, I got that joy, 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 joy down in my heart. Down in my heart. Down in my heart. I got that joy, 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 joy down in my heart. Down in my heart. It's good to be with friends, and we have a great day ahead of us today.
So, what's the deal with St. Paul? He was really an evil man, wasn't he, before he turned to be a Christian?
You know, Eugene, he was a misguided man, but he was not an evil man. I mean, Eugene, St. Paul, he studied the scriptures. He was a great rabbi in the Jewish tradition. I mean, this guy was a great preacher, you know, in the ways of the Judaism, the Jewish religion.
So he wasn't like a terrible sinner or a womanizer or drunk?
No, he was not. The guy, listen, the guy was really, really good. He took religion really seriously.
So why did he hate the Christians?
He felt that they were a threat. A threat to all that had been established in the Jewish religion, and that this new way was gonna, you know, go off and change things, and that this Jesus was, you know, a fake and a fraud.
And the reason why he changed is because he had a personal encounter with Christ.
And that's it, Eugene. You have to have a personal encounter with Christ to have a really a change. From sin and a change from your former way of life. It takes a deep personal encounter.
And that happened on the road to Damascus.
He fell off his horse, as we know from Acts of the Apostles chapter 9. He went blind. He went into Damascus and stayed at Straight Street.
That was the name of the block, right?
So it says it right there, gives you right evidence. A holy Christian guy named Ananias, who lived in Damascus, went and at the instructions of our Lord, placed his hand on him and said, "Be healed and accept Jesus." And at that moment, Paul did.
And that's began a new chapter in his life after his conversion. From then on, he was the friend of Christians, not the persecutor.
Yes. And the funny thing was, the early church at that time, they had to make an adjustment to trust St. Paul, because previously he was a persecutor of Christians, and he said no to Jesus. And now he was a friend of Jesus, and he was an advocate, a protagonist for Christianity.
Stop using those fancy words.
He became like a new apostle.
But he wasn't part of the original 12. Therefore, he was a Johnny come lately.
That's what some of the apostles actually tried to act like. Peter didn't really trust them too much at first, because he's like, "Hey, come on, with your background."
Yeah, but he could have said to Peter, "Well, you were a fisherman before you met Jesus. Like you said, it's all about the encounter with Christ and really accepting to be friends with Jesus, deep friends. And then from there, everything is even for everybody."
That's it. And I love that. And Eugene, you said enough, because I think a lot of times People label others as being, oh, this guy's like this, or this woman, I knew her from years ago, and she's, you know, she had some bad things that happened in the past.
And then they don't trust them anymore, and don't think they can be anything good, or do anything for God, but they can.
And that's it. And I wouldn't want us to label anybody. So I really think that there's a challenge here for us with St. Paul, which is, first of all, always remember when someone has a personal encounter with Christ and a conversion and has a deep friendship with Christ, they can do good things, even if in the past they had made mistakes and went in a different direction. And then, you know, it's funny how St. Paul had to believe that himself, and he took a little retreat and then he went right out and started preaching the good news of Christ.
All right, that's enough, because the readings were long today.
Yeah, the readings were long, but I really, I'm grateful that, man, St. Paul, I could go on and on, but we'll talk more about him in the next few days. He did so many great things, really beautiful, for the church. He was really like a super apostle, even though he wasn't part of the original 12. That guy, man, he knocked it out of the park.
Just look here. How many books did he write in the New Testament? Letters.
Tons of them. Anyway, we'll talk about it another time, but St. Paul, he's our focus today.
Bye, everybody.